So in the previous class, we discussed about the URLs and we also discussed about the MIME types. I hope you remember the MIME types. Like this MIME basically helps for the browser to get access or to access a particular file type. So when we are searching something on the internet, the file type can be, it can be a document or it can be a audio file or it can be a video file and so on and so forth. So to get access such kind of documents, this MIME will help the browser to know which type of file the user wants or which type of file the user has requested. So for that, we use this MIME type. And let go ahead with the next concept, that is the hypertext transfer protocol. So this is the basic protocol through which a user can, or basically a browser can connect to the web server and get the information. Basically, we can download the files or we can watch some videos or we can send some data. Okay, all the time we will not just downloading some documents or we are not searching some documents. Sometimes user is also sending some data. Like for example, you want to fill up a form for your online examination. So, or you are filling some online application or you are just creating a email account. So in such situation, you are sending the data from browser to the server or to the web server. So how these things are handled? So for that, we are going to study about the HTTP two phases. Basically, we categorize into request phase and response phase that we'll be discussing. But before studying to that, the HTTP has evolved over the years and we have got different versions of HTTP. So basically, we know that HTTP is a protocol and we know that a protocol is nothing but a set of guidelines or rules. So when two systems or a client and a server wants to communicate, they should follow a proper standard. Like two students are speaking in French or they want to speak in English. So they have to follow a particular standard. Okay. So similar to that, when a client wants to request something, it has to specify the standard. Like HTTP has got different standards. The latest one currently is being available is 2.0. But from the textbook point of view, we will be referring to the version HTTP 1.1. So this will specify, and suppose say the client is requesting for some particular document or some file and is using the version as 1.1, the same should be used by the server as well. So always two communicating devices should follow the same protocol and also the version as well. So for this, there is a standard that is being given by the Worldwide Consortium. So we have something called as Worldwide Consortium. So if you go to this website, www.w3.org. So if you go to this website, here you'll get all the different standards. Like every protocol has got different standards or some protocols have been standardized. So what are the standardized protocols? All those related information you can get on this. So it will give all the information related, what all protocols are required and all other details. Okay. What are the standards that we have, other things. So these will be given in this particular website, that is Worldwide Consortium. So this version 1.1 was introduced or it was standardized in 1999. And from there, we call this as the standard defined in RFC 2616. Like we have some ISS standards from some products. Similarly, for these protocols, we have to follow some standards that is given by this Worldwide Consortium. And this HTTP protocol consists of two phases. First one we call as the request phase and next one is called as the response phase. So each HTTP communication, whether we are dealing with a request or a response between a browser and a web server, consists of two parts. So it basically consists of a header part and then it consists of the body part. So let us understand this, what basically happens. So consider this as a HTTP client. So he wants some files or he wants to search for some documents. So through the browser, you type a particular URL and that URL will be passed to the web server and here your data will be there or the information will be there. So that information you will get back in terms of a response. So whenever you are accessing some files or you want to download some files, whatever your task you want to do, so you are just sending a request method. So and so document is required for me. Can you give me this? So then this HTTP server will check whether this request is correct or no, whether it is valid or no. If it is valid, then well, it will send the response. So for this to happen, the request and response to happen, we need to follow some proper formats. So what are those formats that we'll be discussing? Like a structure we'll be having for a common C program, we'll be having a structure. So similar to that, we have a proper syntax that we have to use when we want to request some information. So basically we'll be writing this information in our HTML code or PHP scripts. But as of now, you'll be studying about what are these two phases are. But programmatically, you will not understand how these things will happen, because this we'll get to know about when we discuss about all the basic tags, forms, other things, submit buttons and so on. At maybe after another 20-30 classes, we'll understand what is happening. So we are going to study about what is the HTTP request and what is its format we are going to study. And most of the time you might have seen, like when you want to access some particular file or when you type some URL, you will get a response saying that 404. So that means that the file that you want to access or the URL that you have typed in the browser, it is an invalid one. So in this way, you will get the response. So there should be a proper communication should happen between a client and the server. So that will be done with the protocol, that is the HTTP protocol. So what will happen in the request phase and what will happen in the response phase, that we'll be studying in the today's class. So what is the basically a general syntax or the structure will have for the request phase? So the general form will have this, the four lines it will have basically. The first line will consist of HTTP method, domain part of the URL, and then the HTTP version. Then we'll be having header fields, blank line, and the message body. So we are going to study one by one in detail. Okay, so the first line, or this can be considered as a general form for the HTTP request. So first one we call as the request line, and then we have the header lines. There can be n number of header lines, and then there is a blank line, and then we have something called as the body, or the entity body also we can call. So what is this request line will consist of? Request line will consist of a method, then space, followed by the URL, that is the universal resource locator. Okay, so that we will have, or we can say that a uniform resource locator, and then followed by that there will be a space, then the HTTP version, which version of HTTP we are using, and then followed by a optional carriage return, or we can say it as a blank space. Then below that we'll be having the header lines, and then there is again a blank line, and then we'll be having the body. So let us take an example and understand this. So this is a simple example. The following is an example for the first line of HTTP request. So whenever you are doing some request, you need to follow this particular syntax, we can say. So what will be the first line? The first line will include the HTTP method, domain part, and then the HTTP version. So this HTTP method can be one among these. It can be get, post, and so on. We'll be studying that. Just take an example of the first line of the HTTP request. So it will have a get, then space, then forward slash. Then here it will have the complete domain name. So it can have only the domain name, or it can have the domain name followed by the absolute path, we can say, where that particular file is located. So here just they have taken that storefront.html, then space HTTP version. So here the HTTP method that we are using is get. So in the request phase, we have some standard methods. So what are these methods and what are the applications of that method, we'll be studying now. So when I want to request some information, or when I want to access some particular file, what we have to do, we have to specify the method, then followed by the domain part, and then the HTTP version. So this browser will take this information, it will send to the web server, and it will search for this particular file. So it will search in the root directory where this storefront.html is available, and if it is available, it will give a response, and that response is visible on the web browser. So we'll be studying about what are these methods are actually. So consider that we have a method called as get, and what is the meaning of it? It returns the contents of the specified document. So when we use the method as get, what basically we are trying to do, we are requesting the server to return a particular page. It can be student.html, it can be students information can.html, and so on. So we are just trying to access some information from the server. So for that, we use the method called as get, returns the contents of the specified document. So if you use the method as get, you will get that particular document, or you'll get that particular information. Similarly, we can have different methods like head, post, put, delete. What these basically will do. So if you use a method called as head, instead of using the method as get in place of this, if you use the method called as head, what it will basically it will do, it returns the header information for the specified document. So here the user is trying to access the document called as storefront.html. So it will have some information related to this particular file, like for example, what is the file size, or what is the file type, whether it is a HTML file, or whether it is a document file, or whether it is an audio file, and so on. So related to those information we can get if we use the method called as the head. So it returns the header information for the specified document. And then we have a method called as post. It executes the specified document using the enclosed data. For example, consider that these two are related to, like for example, you may be using or you want to access some files or documents. For that, we can use this get and head methods. Gautam, mute yourself. So when you have typed some URL on the browser, and if the method you are using is get and head, then you are just trying to access some information, or you want to access some particular document. But always you are not going to just access some information. Sometimes we will be putting some information, or we are sending some information through the URL as well. For that, we use the method called as the post method. So let us take a simple example. Consider that, or we can take a form, simple HTTP form. So let us consider that this is a HTML form, or consider this as a HTML form. So here, assume that you are typing your name, email ID, password, phone number, your gender, and so on. So this is what we call it as a form. So this you will understand actually when we start about the HTML programming part. We have different tags for the labels, for the text boxes, for the radio buttons and buttons, and so on. So that time you'll understand. So if this is the thing that you are doing on a web browser, so you'll fill all these details, and what you will do, you'll click on the submit button. So when you click on the submit button, what is actually happening? So whatever information you have entered here, that information is passed through the internet, and it will be stored it in the server or in the respective database, we can say. So in this particular case, you are not accessing something. So rather than that, you are sending some information to the server. So in such situations, we use the method called as the post method. So it executes the specified document using the enclosed data. So it will execute that particular application. Or suppose say that you are creating some email IDs, okay, or you are creating your Aadhaar card. So for that, when you open this, or for example, the latest one, if you consider that you are registering for your vaccination, so you'll go to the Cowin website. There you will write all your details or phone number. OTP will come. I mean, you will enter the phone number, and the moment you click on submit, a OTP will be generated. So you are trying to run some application, or you are trying to access that particular application. So when you enter your phone number and when you click on submit, you'll get the OTP. So that OTP is nothing but a response, and the number that you are type, and when you click on that submit button, that is a request that you are doing to that particular domain. So the moment you put on the submit button, your mobile number is transferred. So to do such activities, when you want to send some information, or when you want to put some information to the particular domain or to that particular database, we can say we use the method called as the post method. So it executes the specified document using the enclosed data. So whatever data you are sending, it can be your phone number, your name, age, gender, and so on. So those data together, it will go to that particular link and it will be stored there. Similar to that, we can have something called as put, and we also have the method called as the delete. So this put method replaces the specified document with the enclosed data. For example, consider that I have another file called as student.html, and I'm using a method called as, instead of say get, if I use the method called as put, so if I use the method called as put, so in this, and I'm enclosing some data. So I'm sending some data, that student name, phone number, email, so on. So these all details will be stored inside the student.html when I use the method called as the put method. So basically what it will does, it will replace the specified document with the enclosed data. Or for example, in another request, instead of changing this name and other things, I may be interested in student's phone number, or I may be interested in student's blood group and other related information. So in such situations, so it can be like this. So when I'm attaching this as the data, like blood group and age, so inside this student.html, whatever information is there, into that I'm adding these details. So for such cases, I can use the method called as the put. It replaces the specified document with the enclosed data. And then the last method that we have is the delete. So this method is used to delete some specified document. Basically, this delete method is not used, or it will not be available for the public, because if this is available, then anyone can delete some important information from the server. So, but this will not be used, but it just deletes some specified document. So this is what we have with related to the HTTP request methods. Very, very important. What are the HTTP request methods? So you need to type the method and its description. And you can take one simple example like get storefront.html, add post, and so on. Are we clear with this? The first line of the general form of HTTP. So we'll be having the method, then followed by the domain part with the URL, and then HTTP version. So if you are using the method as get, we are trying to access some information. If your the method is head, then it returns the header information. It will return the information about that particular document, like it can be its created date, time, or other information, how much byte it requires for that particular document, and so on. And then the post method, when we are trying to send some data, or when we want to run some application or execute the specified document, for such cases, we use the post method. Similarly, we can have put and the delete methods. So these are the methods that we will be using. Apart from this, also there are some other methods as well. But for our syllabus will be using only these methods. So that is the first line, and followed by this we have the second line that we call as the header fields. Are we getting it, everyone? Yes. Are you following? We have the second line, that is the header fields. So what are these header fields will consist of? Like in this, this is the general format. Here we have this request line and followed by the header lines. So header lines will always have the header field name, colon, then value, and then a optional blank line or the carriage return. So that is about the header lines. So there can be n number of header lines. And always remember that always the methods that we are using, always the method should be in uppercase letters. Okay, they cannot be used in small case. So the format of the header is the field name followed by a colon and the value of the field. So what this header is all about? Header will give you some information about the document or the request that you are doing. So those information you can get with the header field. So the header field has the four categories, that is the general, request, response, and entity. So what this general will give? So the general is nothing but the for the general information such as the date, time, all those information you can get it from the general. And if the header field is request, then it is included in the request header. Similarly, we can have response and then the entity. So what are this header is all about? So header, for example, we can consider this as an example for the header. So it will have the field name. Okay, the field name can be accept and then followed by a colon and the value of the field. So for general, we can consider the header as the date, or we can have the time. So if you are using that as the header, then it will give the for how much time the document was available, or when the document was used, or who has requested it. So such basic information you can get it if the header is of type general. And if it is of type request, okay, the header can be of type request, it is included in the request headers. So for the request, like for the method, what we use example for the method, we use as the get method, post method, and so on. Similarly, for the request, the example can be accept. So accept is an example for the request header. Okay, try to understand this. For the example here, HTTP method. So for this, we consider the get as an example, put as an example, okay, post as an example. So these are the methods for the HTTP methods. Similarly, for the request headers here, if I'm using the request as the header, then the example can be this accept colon space text slash plain. The format header field is the field name followed by a colon and the value of the field. So the value of the field I'm using here is text slash plain. So this means that I am requesting something and I want to, or the document is of type text and it belongs to the category of plain. So otherwise I can also use another example like accept colon text slash HTML. So this means that the file is of type text and it is a HTML. So if you want to specify it in a general way, so for that we can use the asterisk character, that is a wildcard character, we can say. So whether it belongs to HTML or plain and so on, we can use star symbol or we can call it as the asterisk. So it can be used to specify that part of the MIME type, that can be anything. So a file can belong to any type. It can be a text, it can be an image, audio, and so on. So to understand for the browser, it will help the MIME type. So for that we use the request. Similarly, we can use the response for response headers, and also we can have the entity. So apart from this example, except, we can have also the example called as the host. So what this host will do? Host will indicate the host request header field used to specify the internet host and the port number. And we also discussed about some port numbers. Port numbers are nothing but the to access particular service. For email, we have a different port number. For database, we have a different port number, and so on. So for all the different services, we have some particular port numbers. So this host request header field is used to specify the host name and the port number of the resource being requested, for which particular host we are requesting. Or whether I'm using the email service, then my port number will be so and so. If I'm using FTP, my port number will be so and so. So for that, we use this host as the request. Are we getting it? So for a time being, just understand what are the methods and what will be the structure. This you will actually understand when we create the forms or when we create the applications. That time you'll understand. But as of now, just try to understand the two phases of HTTP protocol, that is the request phase and the response phase. And once we finish with this header fields, then we'll be having the blank line. So we have finished with this first line, and then there can be header lines, and then there will be a blank line, and followed by that we'll be having the entity body. So when you are using this methods called as get and head, you are not sending any data. So if your methods are get, head, then the body will not be there. So body is the space, or the body is the line where you are actually sending some data. So if you are using the method as get or head, then you are not going to send any data. But whereas if you are using the method as post, put, or delete, then you will be using this entity body, and at this particular place you are going to send the respective data. So this is the request header that we have. This is the request phase, and this is the structure of a request phase. Apart from this, we can have other examples as well, like entity headers. Allow is an entity header, which will allow the list, the set of methods supported by that. So what all methods that we have? So if we have the methods like get, head, put. So if you want these related information, then we can use the headers called as allow. So that can be also used. So these are the entity headers. Are we getting it? No response at all from your class.